everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on the Vampire Counts and Vargeist. I'm going to continue working on the wings here today. What I'm going to try and do is knock out this outer portion of this right wing over here, and then probably do this top and top center section of the left wing. That way I can keep all of my highlights in a similar manner. I was considering gumming into the inside of the wing here, but then I'd be highlighting upside down because the highlights are reversed. So I figured, you know what, let's just be consistent and just try to knock out all the outside highlights first. So that's what we're going to do. Now this one, the way this thing is curved, we're going to have a lot more highlight color up here on the top than we have in these lower sections down here, just because the curve of this thing is nowhere near as dramatically rolled outward as the lower parts of this wing are, the lower sections of the wing. So this will be a little bit brighter up here than it would ordinarily be on the lower parts that we've already done. But that's okay. Just kind of, I don't know if you can see it or not, but there's a pretty clear shadow line running like right there, and then it kind of hooks to the side right in that area there. So that's kind of what I'm following, is just roughly where my lights on the table are casting a shadow. And you can do that for your own miniatures as well. Just essentially hold them under a light, kind of figure out how the shadows bounce, or how the light bounces off of them, how the shadows play a little bit, and it'll give you a pretty good indication of where to put your highlights. I'm going to kind of cut most of the highlighting off right here. I'll do a little bit down in this area, but I'll start leaving those crevices in place. I keep getting these white specks on this guy. I don't know why. It's very, very odd. By the way, the paint that I'm using for this is incredibly thin. It's not thin enough to see through, but it's not thick enough to make a solid, really clear delineation color. Definitely don't want a hard break on these color changes. So just trying to keep things relatively subtle. And just sort of feathering that lower edge out just a little bit to kind of help the blend. And again, make it not look like there's some sort of a huge, harsh edge on the lower edge here, where the shadows begin. And I also have to do this sort of edge of the wing here as well in that section. Haven't had to do that yet because the edge, for the most part, down here has been facing the opposite direction. Now we get into something unique and something different. And that's okay. I like unique and different. Okay. I think that's pretty darn good. For our first highlight up, that'll work just fine. Alright. I'm going to go ahead and pull my dust brush back out because, like I said, I keep getting these weird white specks, and it's kind of annoying me, so I'm just going to hit it with the dust brush a little bit, and we'll transfer over to the other side here, and let's see what we can do over here on this side. This area here is pretty much straight up and down, so I'm going to try to leave most of the crevices in place, and just add in a little bit of this highlight color pretty much all over everything except the cracks and the crevices. Okay. All right. Hit a little bit more down there, too. There we go. This one, we've got a curve under right there. You can clearly see the shadow line running like right along that section right there. So this one's a good one to highlight. It's got a nice texture to it. Or a nice curve to it, which makes the shadow real easy to see. I'm just going to kind of pull a rough line of color, feathering that edge out. And then kind of pull it back up here, out of the shadows. come in and fill in the rest. How's everybody doing today? Hadn't asked that yet. Always like to ask. Hope everybody is having a wonderful day. And I'm having a good day here. Love any day when I could sit down and paint something up. There were times in years past when I wouldn't have said that. But I've learned painting is a very cathartic, it's very very relaxing hobby. And so I quite enjoy taking time to just sit down at the table and see what kind of awesomeness I can create, you know? It's fun. Alright, so that's taken care of. Let's add a little bit more of that highlight color in. Show you what I'm doing here. I know that you guys have probably seen this before, but just picking up a little bit of that highlight color in my brush, going to my water, dunking it in a little bit. So I'm going to add a little water to the mixture as well. Mix it a little bit, go back to the water, pick up a little blob of water, and mix it in again. And there you go. We've got our highlight color. Our next one in line, anyway. Got at least four highlights on this thing, maybe five, depending on how quickly I move through them. We'll see. This is the top section here is a little bit larger section than the others, so I may do a little bit of extra highlighting work just to kind of bring some of that stuff out a little bit more. Now is where on the top I need to go ahead and start fleshing in some of these crevices. Just gently leaving some of the cracks and crevices behind. Okay. Boy, I love doing this. I hope you do too. I've gone through periods before where painting is, let's call it a challenge. To say that I hated the idea of picking up a paintbrush would honestly be putting it lightly. I don't ever want to get back there. That was not a fun place to be, and I don't recommend that you go to that place either. Painting should always be a joy. It should be something fun you get to do, and just to create a unique piece of art. A little more careful down here on the bottom. This is where our shadows really start to pick up heavily. So just gently working this color in, leaving some of the cracks behind. I'm actually kind of creating my own shadows as well by not painting in some of the previous highlight color. Or not painting over some of the previous highlight color. Allows some of that to shine through and kind of create a shadow where there necessarily wasn't one. Sculptor decided not to sculpt something in that section. That's fine. But I want a shadow there. So I'll put one in. Bring that highlight down just a little bit there and there. Maybe a little here and here. Just to kind of little length to some of these. Pick up a little more color in the brush. And kind of just work in some of these smaller areas in kind of a streaky sort of motion. Just creating the effect of like a membranous sort of quality. Bit of transparency to it. Not a solid item, so it's got a lot of see-through areas, a lot of lot of different colors and texture if you were to put a light behind it. It's kind of fun to do something like this. Okay. Call that part pretty good, although I'm not 100% satisfied with this section down here, but we'll see how we change once we start adding in a little bit of shade color in there as well. For right now, though, I'm going to switch over to this side. I'll just focus on the top. Just kind of working my way down a little bit there, maybe a touch there, and here, and here. Nothing major. All right, here, just want to catch the tips of the edge right in this area here, just to kind of create a little bit of a highlight. Nothing major in that spot. And over here, we can start pulling the highlights more fully. Even those crevices. You always want to have some dark areas on your miniature. I know I tout the benefits of a nice bright miniature a lot, but brightness doesn't work unless you've also got darkness in the model as well. So it just creates a good areas of contrast, and contrast is what creates interest on your miniatures. Bright colors help, definitely, but bright colors without dark really messes things up just as much as dark colors without bright. So. Alright, let's grab a little bit more paint here. And we'll just grab another little dot of that highlight and mix that in. There we go. More water to thin it out some more. Now let's grab the brush again and pick up some more paint and go back to it. Alright, so this time we're going to really focus. I'm going to actually start on the bottom this time to kind of help myself out with these areas that I'm not overly satisfied with. We'll just add in a few little kind of brighter highlight spots here as we come down. That's not bad. I think we can live with that. Just making sure that my brush is at a nice point and using it almost like a fine tip pen or pencil. Okay. That's pretty good. I think we need a little bit more in this area to kind of help break up that little ridge. Okay, that's not bad. I like that. And then we'll come up here. We'll start hitting these areas pretty heavily up here since there's a lot of light on these sections. Instead of coloring at this point, I'm really truly just kind of drawing in streaks. Just little veins or lines of color, basically. Just to help to create texture. I should probably look at the clock on the camera, see how long I've been going. Because I have no idea. Let's see. Okay, 14 minutes. Good, I should be able to finish both of these, or all three of these wing sections. It'll be nice if we can do that. A little more paint for just the tip of the edge here. Okay, so now you can see we've got some good color in there. It kind of matches the others. It's not quite as bright yet, so we need at least one more highlight in there. But it's starting to have some texture to it, which is cool. That's exactly what we want. So I'll go to the other side now, and I'll do the same thing here. Just, adding in a few little streaks here and there. Okay. Might even go ahead and hit the top of this just for fun in case I don't get it on the other side. Alright. And then we'll do the same thing in this area here. Paint. I know this is not meant to be a tutorial. I say that, or I have said that many, many times in the past when doing these Watch Me Work videos. It's really just a series where you get to watch a piece of art get created, maybe, hopefully, at least, while you you paint something of your own. You just have this on in the background, and something comes up that you might want to see, you just go back and take a look at it again. But I do want to, if you're interested, know how I'm getting such thin lines. Basically what I do is I take my brush and I just barely roll the tip of it. And so I've got about maybe half of a brush full on the brush right here. So only about half the bristles are full. Just roll it in the paint to pick up some paint. And then usually that puts too much paint on the brush, so what I'll do is I'll come to my paper towel and I'll just take it and I'll roll it a second time on the paper towel to reestablish the point. And it just pulls some of that excess paint off, and it basically gives me a nice, sharp point to work with a minimal amount of paint. And it works really, really well at creating very fine lines. So, just a quick tip for those of you interested in drawing little fine lines on your miniatures. And then a little more of this highlight color onto my palette, and then mix that in as well, and I think we'll be darn close to being finished. So let's see what we can do here with this. One more highlight, dip it in the water, and mix it in. We'll probably end up going for 25, maybe 30 minutes today, just to be able to have time to do the shadows and things like that on the model. But I don't know, I might save the shadows for next time. Shadows are kind of a lengthy process, so there's no real reason to jump into it and try and get it all done today. But I don't know, we'll see. Let's see what the future holds. Alright, there we go. So that's pretty good. Maybe a few more streaks kind of on down this way, but nothing major. A little bit in there, maybe a touch there, and then we kind of fade off there as far as the highlights go. I'll maybe come down just a little bit further. Not too many of these down here in this area. Do something like that, and maybe a little down there, just a touch here and there, just to kind of bring in a little bit of that brighter highlight color. Okay, pick up a little bit more paint on my brush, and maybe do this a little bit more up here at the top, just to kind of bring it out some, since it is the brightest area. That's pretty good. Dab it with a finger to kind of pick up some of that extra color. But you can see, I mean, now we've got a really, really good defined, or a really well-defined section of breakups and texture on that wing. And obviously, when we do the shadow stuff, all of these colors will kind of be dulled down just a little bit anyway, just like on the other parts of the wing we've already done. Wipe a little more paint out of my brush. I'm leaving a blob of colored water at the end of my streak every time. There we go. Maybe I should stroke upwards instead. That'll help out. Okay. And then we'll come over here and we'll do the same thing, kind of working our way like this. I'm just sort of drawing in the same lines over and over and over again. Really, I mean, when you get right down to it, that's basically what I'm doing. I'm picking one line and just hitting it with the same highlight every single time. Well, not the same highlight. I'm obviously making the highlight smaller and changing the color, but I'm hitting the same spot every time. And in this case, because it's texture I'm trying to create, I'm basically just drawing lines as opposed to doing an actual layering process. So. Nice and simple. Adding in just a little bit more of this paint to make it more opaque, right on the top area of the hump right here, just to kind of make that area look as though it's the part that's in the light the most, or that it's reflecting the most light. So. All right, pretty quick and easy. You can see we've got a pretty good start there on that side. We've got a real good start here on this side as well, and so next time we'll come in, we'll do all the shadow work on those three areas, and make them look like these other three that we've already done here, here, and here, and who knows, I might even get into the highlight work on these bottom two down here, and then we've got eight more sections, all on the inside, so we'll have to reverse the highlights, do all the highlights on the bottom of these, since, as you can see, the shades, or the shadows, are at the top of the wing, and the highlights are down here on the lower side, but we'll do that at some other time. For right now, though, we will call it a video. I want to thank you very, very much for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video, and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already, so you get notified every single time a new video gets posted. I want to thank you once again for watching. It really means a lot to me. God bless you all. Have a phenomenal rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.